Now we are going to cover the first unit in the physics, that is laws of motions. We are going to see the various topics like force, motion, types of inertia, what are the various types of inertia, what is law of motion, the various Newton law, the difference between mass and weight, and what is gravitational effect. Okay, and the effect of gravitation in the bodies with respect to the weightlessness. These are the points we are going to cover in this topic. So first, what is mechanics? Mechanics is a branch of physics that deals with the bodies which are in motion. Okay, if there is an object, this object is being acted upon by force. We have to study these effect of force on the bodies. This study is known as mechanics. When the body is under rest, the study of the body which is under rest is known as statics. And the study of moving bodies which is in motion, it is called as dynamics. Kinematics is the study which studies the cause of motion, what makes the object to move. These are the various branches of physics. Okay, next. What is inertia? We all know when we are moving in the bus, if there is a sudden break, our body tends to move forward. The bus is being stopped, but our body moves forward. That is the tendency of the body to resist the application of the force. It is called as inertia. The inherent property of the body to resist the change in the state of rest or in the state of motion, that is called as inertia. We have various types of inertia like inertia at rest, inertia of motion, and inertia of direction. That is, when the object is in rest, the object resists the application of the force to change the position of rest. This is known as inertia of rest. Okay. That is the resistance of the body to change the state of rest. Similarly, the inertia, the resistance of the body to change the state of motion. If the object is moving, okay, if there is a sudden force being applied, this object has some sort of resistance to the applied force. That is inertia of motion. Then what is inertia of direction? The resistance of the body to change the direction. If the object is being turned in this direction, if the force is being applied here, the object has some resistance to this applied force in the change of direction. Okay. There are many examples of inertia, as I told. When the brake is being applied, our body tends to move forward in a bus. And when we start a vehicle, either a two-wheeler or four-wheeler, when we start, then our body tends to lean backwards. Okay. And when we are going to a high jump or a long jump, an athlete always makes up a warm-up. Okay. To change the state of motion. That is called as inertia of direction or motion. Okay. The next term is, what is linear momentum? That is, if the force is being acted upon a body, the impact of the force is being considered. The impact depends upon the mass of the object and the velocity. Okay. The product of mass and velocity is linear momentum. Okay. The impact of the force on this object is based upon these two factors. Okay, that is linear momentum is equal to mass into velocity. So now we are going to see all the Newton's law, right? What is the first law? That is, the body be in the state of rest or motion unless it is acted upon by some force. Okay, if the body is in rest, the object is always in rest. If the body is in motion, it just moves on. Okay. It moves on unless it is being acted upon by some external force. It remains in the same state. This is what the first law states. Okay. We already know the what is force. To change the state of the object, either to be in rest or motion, the external force is being applied. The pull or push, that is called the force. Okay, there are two types, that is like parallel forces and unlike parallel forces. Okay, like parallel forces means two or more forces of equal act or unequal magnitude. It may be 1 kilonewton or 2 kilonewton, but it acts in the same direction. This is called as like parallel forces. Unlike parallel force, equal magnitude or unequal, one force acts in one direction and the other force acts in another direction. Right? This is unlike parallel force. The resultant force is nothing but, if the object is being acted upon by multiple of forces in all the directions, okay, based upon the mass of the object, the ultimate force is being acted upon by the combined effect of all the forces in one point. This is center of gravity. That is called the resultant force. Okay, you just see here, I'll just address this. Two parallel forces are acting upon a body here. The resultant force is F1 plus F2. In this one, F1 is acting in this direction, F2 is acting in this direction, right? The resultant force is net is F1 minus F2 if F1 is greater. And if F2 is greater, then F2 minus F1. This is the resultant force. Okay? If both are equal, if F1 is equal to F2, then the resultant force is zero. Okay? So these are the combined effect of all the forces acting on the object. That is called as resultant force. Okay? Then, now we are going to an important topic, that is momentum. Moment or couple or the rotating effect. Okay? You just see, this is a door or window. Here is a support. There is a hinges in the wall and we are rotating the door open and close, right, in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. Based upon if the length is greater, then there is a lesser force required to open the door. If the length is so less, then we have to apply more force. Okay, this is the effect between. So the moment is nothing but the force into the perpendicular distance. Right, force into perpendicular distance. This is what the moment. If the distance is higher, then the moment is higher. The rotating force is very, very less. If the distance is less, then the force we are going to apply is very high. Right? So this is what the moment of force. Here comes the term moment of force. That is nothing but force into the perpendicular direction D. This is what the moment. Okay. The next term comes the couple. Couple is nothing but a twisting moment. You just see here in this diagram. The force is acted here. The force is acted here. This makes the objects turn. Okay. Equal and unlike parallel forces. Okay. This makes the object to turn or twist. This is called as couple. The formula for, again, the moment of couple is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. Okay. So, for the application of the torque, we are applying the torque in many, torque or couple or moment in many cases like gear. When we are raising the gear, the torque is being applied in the vehicles, seesaw, okay, then steering wheel. Okay, these are some of the examples of application of torque or couple. Right. Then comes the principle of moment. Okay. Principle of moment is nothing but when a number of force or like parallel, maybe same force or different force, if it is acted upon a body, see this is an object. Okay. So there are a number of forces being acted upon. This is a section. Okay. The algebraic sum of all these moment in the clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction is same. Okay, must be same. Okay, this is what the principle of moment. You just see here, there is a beam, there is a support here, in this point. The force F1 is being acted upon here, F2 is acting here. The F1 makes the anti-clockwise moment and F2 makes the clockwise moment, right? So, at this point, when we are based upon the principle of moment, okay, if the object must be in equilibrium, if the object must be at rest, then the anti-clockwise moment must be equal to the clockwise moment. See here, the anti-clockwise moment is F1 into D1, the distance. The clockwise moment is F2 into D2. Okay, this must be equal to be the object in equilibrium. So this is what the principle of moment states. So from these all equations, we can find out the forces being acted upon. If there is a one known value, then the other unknown factors can be determined by these factors. Okay. So these are the topics covered in this chapter, in this class. We'll see the remaining Newton's second law, third law, the effect of gravitation, okay, the weightlessness effect in the universe or in the atmosphere in the next class. So thank you, everybody.